I'm very good at a lot of things. I'm very talented at a lot of things.
I can kick a goal from 78 metres out on a 45 degree angle with a blindfold on. If there was a wild boar running around here, right now, I'd be able to lasso it, reel it in, rip off its head, and use its tusk as a pipe. When it comes to girls, I'm a shambles. All my friends have girlfriends. Even Jim, and he's got red hair and glasses. And they all go,
Hey Benny, where's your special young lady?
I just go, oh, I don't know. I haven't found her yet. But I have. She catches my train every morning. The 6:42 from Pemberton Station. I saw her for the first time exactly 12 months ago today. I caught the early train by mistake because I got confused by daylight savings. I remember I hopped on, the train was packed, I was looking around for a seat. And there at the end of the carriage, there she was. She was staring out the window, her head resting against the glass. She wore a navy blazer, brown checkered skirt, black lace-up shoes. She had curly brown hair that fell down her face like chocolate spaghetti. I want to go up and hug her. I want to eat her up. But I didn't. Instead, I just stood there like an idiot and watched from a distance. I went 4 extra stops because I couldn't take my eyes off her. Since then, I've caught the same train every morning, and every day I tell myself, just go up and say hi. But I don't. Instead, I sit at the exact opposite end of the carriage and I spend the whole time trying to dream up all these crazy events that could happen that would give me an excuse to go up and introduce myself. Like when we're going through the tunnel in the city, I pray there'll be an avalanche and everything will cave in and everyone will be knocked unconscious. Except us two. And then after a while, I'll be able to crawl on over and offer a bite of my chicken sandwich. Or some nuts. I've even started packing an extra lunch just in case. I have this other dream where the night before the entire world gets attacked and killed by a plague of killer locusts. And when I rock up in the morning, she's there, demands we hook up so we can reprocreate the world's population. I'm a loser. You know, I particularly look forward to summer because I could wear sunglasses and look at her from the right and still appear to be facing forward. Today was different. The 12 months, the 1 year anniversary, a cause for something special. So you know what I did? I got up and I walked on over. And there she was, staring out the window. And I just sat down and I said hi. And my heart was racing and my feet were all jittery. And then she looks over with these deep brown eyes and she says hi. Well, I didn't know what to do, so I just started talking. I talked the entire 28 minutes it took to get from Pemberton Station into the city. And when we got there, well, she had to go off to work, so well, she went her way, and I went my way, and that was it. She said she'll see me again next Monday.